someone artifacts anything made by people who lived a long time ago?
Oh, exactly, Tim. An artifact gives us clues as to how those people lived their lives.
Well, someone made that thing for a reason, right? And once we figure out that reason, we'll know what it is.
So what are we supposed to do?
Yes, you got it, Ralphie. That's what scientists do. They put clues together and make a guess. And they call that guess a hypothesis.
Hypothesis?
Then let me put a few clues together. It's made of wood, and it's pretty strong. Could be some sort of a shield. Maybe a war thing.
Sounds like a hypothesis to me, Ralphie.
I don't know. I think it looks more like a net.
Rigorous testing of Ralphie's hypothesis, we've decided
glasses. Come on, class. Let's make a splash.
Let's go.
This river's filled with fish.
Too bad you can't catch one.
Patience, Moina. Fishing is an art.
So is tightrope walking, but we don't have time to learn it. We need to know what the thing is now.
I don't get it. The big fish just avoid the hoop, and the little ones swim right through the webbing. I'm starting to think this wasn't a fishing net. Contest.
I can't believe this is happening. I go on in 10 minutes. They're out fishing. Hey, quit playing. This is serious business.
Well, it definitely wasn't a fishing net.
And it wasn't any good at paddling through those rapids either. When you think about it, why would they give it all these beautiful colors if they were just going to stick it in the water?
Based on that observation, Keisha, what would you say it is?
Why, a hat, of course. Look how nicely it's decorated. It says here that Joan found shells and beads that people used to decorate their clothing. Maybe they had special ceremonies. Let's suppose it was a hat used as part of a dance celebration.
Let's send that idea up the flagpole. Let's suppose we have some dancers. Bada bing, bada boom, a few drums.
Remember Joan wrote that the people were farmers? So let's suppose it's a harvest ceremony.
Ah, good idea. So we'll have some fields. Some corn. A little bit of nighttime. Celebrations are so much more fun at night. Now let's rock and roll. And if you thought that last challenger was something, get a load of these kids.
Come on, you guys. I'm getting mad. Can't you just pick up a pumpkin and get back here? That's it, Liz. If I catch you playing this priceless artifact one more time, it's chocolate covered hands for a week. Now, what the heck is this thing?
You're on in 5, kid.
Hey, wait a second. There's these arrows. Where'd you... hypothesis to test.
Please, oh, please get back in time. Please, oh, please don't make me go on by myself.
DA! Oh, what a relief.
Here.
Thanks, Arnold. You're leaving me alone again?
Okay, all you gazillions around the world, join me now in welcoming the contestant from our very own Walkerville Elementary School.
Yeah!
of this simple hoop has puzzled archaeologists for ages, as well as my class from last half hour. Turns out to be something every kid is an expert at. A game! The object of the game was probably to get this arrow through the hoop. And if you got the arrow through Venner, you'd get more points than if you got it through this open space near the rim. And how do we know all this?
Take your second night, best mom. I'm a magic school bus. Navigator, nostril. Carnival of Love?